of pride and of hope for the women and for the men in Iran who continue to fight the Mullah's regime in spite of the very real danger.
Civilization. This is a demonstration for the struggle for human rights in Iran. This is a demonstration for the release of political prisoners in Iran. This is a demonstration for the end of the culture of impunity of Iran. And so a free Iran with freed political prisoners will then be able to make its great contribution to the international struggle for human rights and freedom. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cotler. Great pleasure to have you.
With Mullahs, sharing crime with Mullahs.
Shaking hand 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 with Mullahs, sharing crime with Mullahs.
No talk to the Mullahs, no deal with the Mullahs.
No talk to the Mullahs, no deal with the Mullahs.
No talk to the Mullahs, no deal with the Mullahs.
No talk to the Mullahs, no deal with the Mullahs.
Political prisoners in Iran must be freed.
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 Stop torture and execution in Iran.
Stop torture and execution in Iran.
Stop torture and execution.
No deal with the Mullahs.
Shaking hands with Mullahs, sharing crime with 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 Mullahs.
What do we want? Abolition of execution in Iran. What do we want?
Abolition of execution in Iran.
What do we want?
Abolition of execution in Iran.
For the good of the Iranian state, of the Iranian society. And so we stand once more to remember the massacre of 30 years ago of 30,000 Iranians, men and women, most of whom had been incarcerated because of their political action against the regime of the mullahs. La grande majorité étaient membres ou sympathisants des mujahideen. They asked for what? They asked for freedom and democracy. And just a little aparte, which is all we're using. Freedom and democracy is something that we take for granted here in Canada. I was just saying to Sharam as we came out of the parliament, here we are, together, talking about freedom and democracy for Iran, and on the grounds of the Parliament of Canada, and Toronto, à Ottawa, Calgary, Vancouver, ailleurs au Canada, et garante du soutien de la diaspora iranienne à travers le monde. You have successfully made known across Canada and the world the battle against dictatorship and fundamentalism in Iran. I want to salute these organizations present here today. The Iran Democratic Association, the Iranian Women of Tomorrow's Voice, the International Coalition of Women Against Fundamentalism, the Educators for Peace and Democracy, degradation of one or more human beings. They are not isolated or sporadic events, but are part either of a government policy or a wide practice of atrocities tolerated or condoned by your government or a de facto authority. In 2008, 20 years after the murders, Amnesty International called for those responsible to be held accountable for their crimes, but the call went unheeded. The Canadian government has shown leadership in the recognition of the illegal
of the Western world. The Western world is silent. Silence in 1988, it's silent now. It's deafening, the silence. That is a bigger crime than the horrific torture being meted out in prisons across Iran. And you know what? This is not an issue for just Iranian Canadians or Iranian diaspora. This is an issue for all Canadians. I am a Jewish Canadian. I'm here because this issue is important for everybody. not just Iranians. And so let's be clear, we must stand up for freedom, liberty, and democracy. And this regime must go to the ash bin of history as soon as possible. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Justice for Massacre of 88 in Iran.
What do we want?
Justice for Massacre of 88 in Iran.
Justice for Massacre of 88 in Iran! Stop torture and execution in Iran!
Stop torture and execution in Iran!
Stop torture and execution in Iran!
Stop torture and execution in Iran!
Stop torture and execution in Iran!
Stop torture and execution in Iran!
No